Alright, so this is for my ladies who are 18 and up, so if you are not, please keep scrolling. So lately my boyfriend and I have been trying some new stuff in the bedroom. We went on the website Balesa and got some new toys for me. And I want to show you one of them because it's literally my favorite thing on earth. This thing has helped me through some hard times, if you know what I mean. Okay, anyways, I got this toy called the Air from Balesa, and it comes in a little compact like this, which is really nice because if somebody's rooting through your shit, they'll just think, oh, it's makeup. Anyways, this is what it looks like, and it has this little suction cup to stimulate you know what. And it's super nice because if I want to use this late at night, it's super quiet. Look, like what? You know, because sometimes my boyfriend's sleeping. And it probably takes me like 3 minutes to get off with that. Like my boyfriend's going on vacation soon. This thing I will get a lot of use out of. For Valentine's Day, they're having up to 25% off the whole website. So click the link in my bio. Okay, everybody, stop scrolling. So I need your guys' opinion on something. I was thinking last night while I was on the plane how you guys DM me stuff. And I never see your guys' DMs because I always get spam ones. There's this app called Connected to Me, and you can make a profile and you can like message people anonymously. I had an idea that you guys should send in your dirty, weird, funny confessions to me on there, and then I can read them, and you guys don't have to feel scared about sending them to me because they're obviously going to be anonymous. So if you guys like this idea, go click the link in my bio to download the app. And this is my username. It's the same as all my other social medias. And in a couple of days, I will come back and read you guys all of the confessions that you guys sent me.
I'm too emotional. Your apathy is like a wounded soul. Maybe I'm too emotional. Or maybe you never care.
Okay guys, hear me out. Does anybody low-key hate the beauty filter? I know what you're thinking. Hold on. Okay, now look. I have good dimension on my face. You know, like you can see, you know, like kind of the tan, the freckles a little bit. Now it looks like I have a 5 o'clock shadow. And there's no dimension to my face. I mean, there's a little bit, but not as good as this. Like, I don't know. I feel like if you could adjust the filter instead of it just being like one whole big blur, because to be honest, it literally just makes your face look flat, then I'd probably be okay with that because, you know, someday I have blemishes that I just don't want anybody to see. But yeah. Story time about the 2-year-old boy who lost his life at the Pittsburgh Zoo. On a Sunday morning, a mother decided that she was going to take her son to the zoo. Everything was going good until they had gotten to the wild African dog exhibit. I'm going to insert a picture of what it looks like right here. On both sides of the exhibit, there was plexiglass. But looking straight out into the exhibit, there was no glass. They also had a roughly 4.5-foot railing there. Well, as most parents do whenever they take their children to the zoo, they pick them up so that way they can get a better look at the animals. Well, this mom had an idea of standing her child up onto the railing to get a better look at the dogs. Now, me personally, I have been to that zoo before. There are many signs saying not to lean over or set your child onto the railing. Well, in an instant, her child had lunged forward, and she had accidentally let go of him. At 11:45, her child had dropped 10 feet down into the dog enclosure. A few seconds later, the people around her had went to get employees. But by that time, the dogs had already gotten to the 2-year-old boy. Like for part 2. Take a moment to appreciate the friends with strict parents. As
listen, I used to be best friends with this one girl. Her parents weren't strict at all. They let her do whatever she wanted. She would always try to make plans with me last minute, and that just wasn't a thing. And she would get pissed off at me whenever I said no. Because, listen, in order to make plans, I gotta make sure I ask my parents a week in advance. Remind them every day, so that way they don't forget whenever I finally ask, and they're like, I don't know what you're talking about. You're not going. I have to do all the chores leading up to the day that I'm supposed to go out. Or else it's, you didn't do this, this, and this, so you're not going. Gotta make sure the grades look good, because last minute they'll be like, well, how are your grades? I just feel like the friends with strict parents don't get enough appreciation for all the shit that they have to go through in order to hang out with people. Oh, and another thing is my friend wanted to go to this one mall. But my parents would be like, oh, that's like not a good place. It's such a bad neighborhood, blah, blah, blah. Because they just remember how it was whenever they were kids and not how it is now. I would have to make up in a whole ass elaborate story on where I'm going, where I'm gonna be. And she would be like, why don't you just tell them where you're really going?
You know, I see so many comments of people saying, one wipe and it's all gone, blah, 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 blah. My thing is that, like, I literally have the setting on my camera, like, when I'm filming story times and everything, to literally the clearest setting so you can see every single blemish on my face. If that doesn't show you that I don't give a fuck about what you have to say, then I don't know what will, because half of y'all don't even have your faces on your fucking page. Next, please.
Hi, everyone. So today I decided to take one for the team. So you guys probably saw the hack that was going around a while ago, where you exchanged your used Bath & Body Works candles for new ones. So I grabbed one that was filled really low, and then I grabbed two other ones that were filled maybe to the middle. And then I put them all in a bag, and I went to Bath & Body Works. And I decided to put a few other ones in there just because I couldn't remember certain scents that I wanted to get while I was in there. So then I hopped in my car and went to Bath & Body Works. So I exchanged the candles, and sadly they didn't take the one that was filled lower than the other ones. Go to Bath & Body Works and exchange your old candles for new.
Okay guys, so we are back with Confessions Part 2. Now I have not read any of these yet, so if I'm a little slow during the process, that's okay. Yeah, it's gonna take me a long time to read this one. So bear with me. Okay, my dirty confession is I was with this guy, let's call him Grant. I was with Grant for like 2 years. After that, I could not seem to leave him. Every time I'd break up with him, he would get drunk trying to get my attention when he saw me. And he would end up leaving me alone. So one day, I ended up drinking and hooking up with this guy and found out that he was his cousin. And then I started dating his cousin for like 6 years and we broke up because he moved. But moral of the story, never date a 45-year-old, lol. Hope my story gets on TikTok. Love your videos. Oh yeah, I was 17 when this happened. I'm pretty sure this is illegal. But hey sis, you made it on the TikTok! Okay, next confession. Hi, my confession is I want my stepmom. I know it's horrible, but she's constantly telling me I'm not good enough. She hurts me. She treats my other sisters better. She even says she's better than my real mom. She tells me stuff like, your mom doesn't care about you. It just hurts me too much and I can't handle it anymore. Anybody else hear my neck crack whenever I went? Anyways, I'm very sorry that she treats you like that, but don't do anything I wouldn't do. Just think about it. You'll be 18 before you know it. Hey, so I had a best friend who tried to... my boyfriend because she was in love with me. See, I don't know why all of a sudden the confessions are starting to get dark. You should probably tell somebody about this. So one time I was at a friend's house and we were drinking. I was 15 at the time. My parents were at work. There were boys there and girls, of course. We talked for a little and my friend got super drunk and started taking all of her clothes off. We were like, girl, put your clothes back on. So then she fell and farted in front of everyone. Shake my head, we all started laughing. After that, she ignored us all for a week. That's embarrassing. And y'all are messed up for that. A confession is what you wanted, right? What do you mean by confession? Okay, well, I hooked up with my best friend's brother before. Get it, sis? The guy I like is dating one of the girls that bullied me. He won't tell me if they are really dating, but I'm terrified to find out whenever I go back to school. If he won't tell you, then you need to cut him off. Because any guy who likes you or guy who is just your friend would not be dating a girl who bullies you. In primary school, I had a boyfriend named Sam. Me and him were on and off all year. One day, I went to go see my friend and spend the night at her house. My boyfriend at the time was saying how he can see me outside. Creepy. But he really wasn't there. Later that night, he asked me for nudes. I told my friend, OMG, he wants nudes. I sent them and I went to school on Monday and found out the whole school knew about it. And I had to talk to my counselor, my principal, my assistant principal, and a few more other teachers. He got expelled from the school and I finished year 6. I mean, hey, at least he got expelled. Like and comment if you guys want a part 3. Hi everyone, so tonight I thought I would show you guys my night routine. So obviously the first thing that I do is put a headband in and get my hair out of my face. I use this face wash by the Purity brand that literally is a makeup remover and a face wash. It helps to get off all the excess makeup that my micellar water might have missed. And I literally love using my Foreo because it helps get in my pores so much better than using my hands. Next, I get one of my soft ass face towels, and I like using those better because they're not as rough on my skin. Then I use my bomb ass moisturizer that literally helps get rid of all my redness. Then I go to my fridge and I get my Revita products. So the first thing that I like to put on is my Revita brow, and this stuff works so freaking good for growing out your brows. Definitely recommend. Then I use my Revita lash, because all the fake lashes and lash glue have been ripping out my eyelashes. And since it's cold as fuck up here in Pittsburgh, I just put some Vaseline on my lips, and that is my night routine. Hi everyone, so a lot of you have been asking for a makeup tutorial, so I thought I would do my natural look today. So the first thing that I do is I put my headband on, and then I go in with my favorite moisturizer. And then I go in with my favorite primer by Laura Mercier. And most of the products today are going to be used by Laura Mercier. It's not sponsored or anything like that. I literally just love their products for like a natural look. And this is their skin tint. I like this honestly for like beginner makeup. It's not full coverage like foundation, but it definitely helps even out your skin tone. Then I go in with their camouflage stick, and I just put this everywhere where I usually would conceal, which is under my eyes, on my chin, and I don't like to do my forehead. Now it's time for me to contour my nose. And now I just blend it out with my favorite Real Techniques brush. And I make sure to blend it into my concealer as well. And now I go in with my setting powder, and I just bake everywhere that I put concealer. If you want to see me finish this look, go to part 2.